Hello friends, welcome to our channel Castor Classes, and in this particular video I am going to discuss some important concepts related to strings in Python. Already in my previous video I have discussed many concepts related to string in Python. If you want to check those videos, please go through the link given in the description. Okay, so let's start. I have told you that we can define a string using double quote or single quote. Like here, I am using double quote to define this string, okay? S equal to hello world. Then print S. As soon as I click control and enter or shift and enter, we will be getting hello world directly, okay? Now, I also told you, if we want to use double quote inside a string which is defined using double quote, like here, the string is defined using double quote, Now I want to use one double quote inside this string. Suppose in between hello and world, I want to give one double quote. What will happen? If I run, we will be getting error. Why? Because this particular double quote will be treated as the ending of the hello string. As a result, if you consider the world part of this string, here ending quote is there, but no beginning double quote. So as a result, world part is not defined properly. So we will be getting error. But to avoid that, what I told you, that we have to give one escape character. If we give escape character or this particular backslash, what will happen? The next character, the immediate next character will be treated differently. Okay, so this particular double quote will be not treated as a normal double quote. Okay, and it will be printed simply. See, hello and world, and in between hello and world, there is one double quote. Okay, so this particular backslash, I told you same. Like if you want to use single quote inside a string which you have defined using single quote, then also you can use this particular backslash or escape character. See, hello and world, and in between hello and world we are getting one single quote. If you remove this, same, you will be getting one error. This already I have discussed. Now let us discuss some more about this particular escape character. Suppose I am writing hello in world. Okay, if I run, see, hello and world, and in between hello and world we are getting in. So this particular in is treated as normal character. Now I am giving escape character. So what will happen? This in will no longer be treated as normal character. It will be treated differently. And you know what is that? N is treated as new line. Okay, so this particular backslash N will indicate one new line. So hello will be printed in a line, and in a new line world part will be printed. If I run, see, hello, and then in a new line we are getting world. Same, like simply write, if we write T, hello T world, we will be getting hello T world. But if you give backslash then T, this T will be treated as tab. So as a result, in between hello and world we will be getting one tab. If we run, see, in between hello and world we are getting one tab. Okay, so these are some important application of escape character. Now what may happen in some practical scenario while you are mapped in a, suppose, practical project, real-time project. Now you are writing the code, but for the time being you don't want to execute like special thing, like you don't want to execute this backslash T as tab, okay, or backslash n as new line. You want to write that, you want to execute that as it is, like you want to get hello backslash t world as it is. Then how you can do that? Simple, you have to use raw string concept in Python. Raw string, if you write just r in the beginning of this string, it will be treated as raw string and it will print as it is, that is hello backslash t world. This backslash t will not be treated as tab. Okay, see, I am running the code and I will be getting hello backslash t world. Same in case of raw string, if you give a backslash n, directly you will be getting hello backslash n world. But if you remove the r, you will be getting hello and world in separate lines. Okay, so this is the raw string concept present in Python. And last concept which I want to discuss in my this video, that is writing a string in multiple lines. Okay, so suppose I have a huge line, huge sentence which will not be, can be not which cannot be written in a single line. So what we can do, I have written in two lines, okay, hello and then world. So now if I run, I will be simply getting error, because when compiler will run the code, what it will do, it will get here the beginning of the string, but it will not be getting any ending string. So as a result, it will throw error. Now how to write the code or a string, how to define a string in multiple lines? For that, there is a concept present in string in Python, that is triple quote. Okay, what you do, you define triple quote, and inside the triple quote, see what I am doing, I have defined triple quote, and inside the triple quote I am writing my string. Okay, see, hello is written in a line, world is written in the next line, but I have used triple quote to define this string. The triple quote is used to define a string in multiple lines. If I run, see, hello and world we are getting in different lines without any error. Not only this triple single quote we can use triple double quote also. Like here, let me use hello world. See, triple double quote I have used. If I run, same thing we are getting, hello world. But you should never do like this. Like you are starting is single quote and then ending is double quote. Now if I write hello world, see, starting we have used triple single quote, in the ending we have used triple double quote. Simply we will be getting error because these are mismatch. Either use all the three quotes as single quote, or use all the three quotes as double quote in beginning as well as in the ending part. So this is how triple quoted string can be used to define a string in multiple lines in Python. And one more simple concept which may be used to increase the code readability, that is how to give comment in Python. Very simple, you have to use hash. This particular hash is used to define comment in Python. Okay, so like here, let me write, I'm writing hello world simple. Okay, so print the string. Okay, so print the string is treated as simply one comment. Now if I run, see, hello world, it is printed. So this particular part obviously it will not be executed, this will be treated as comment. So hash is used to denote the comment part in Python. Okay, so this is all about this string video. I will show you some competitive programming and widely or frequently asked interview questions also related to string, so that you will get a clear idea, a complete idea, and it will help you in your placement process as well as building the logical skills in programming also. So this is all for my this video. If you find this video helpful, please like, share and comment. Don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the latest video notification from our channel. Okay, thank you for watching.